Pray for each other as we do, we come together in any group of different people. And finally, we ask that God will grant a merciful judgment to Shimei in this time. We come into the presence of the Lord, we acknowledge that we have sinned ourselves. We ask God for his mercy. I confess to Almighty God
and to my brothers and sisters
that I have really sinned
in my thoughts and in my words.
Therefore I ask that the Spirit of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray. Pray for me, Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let's pray. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of saints, grant we pray to your servant ships, for whom we perform the offered office of burial, assure with your chosen ones the blessings that you give. On the day of resurrection, free from the bonds of mortality, may he come before your face, your Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity with the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Right, Anya and Daniela now to come and read us the scripture.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud unwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Be still, my soul. The Lord is on my side. Grief and pain lead to thy God to order and provide. In every change he faithful will remain. Be still my soul, thy best, thy thorny ways lead to a joyful end. Be still my soul when dearest friends depart and all is darkened in the veil of tears. Then shall thy sorrow and thy fears. Be still my soul, the waves and winds shall know his voice will rule them while he dwells below. Be still my soul, the listening on when we shall be forever with the Lord. When disappointment, grief and fear are gone, sorrow forgotten, love's purest joy restore. Be still my soul when change and tears are past. All safe and blessed we shall meet at last.
First letter of St. John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are, because the world refused to acknowledge him. therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he really is. The word of the Lord.
Soon afterwards, Jesus went to a town called Nain, and his disciples and the great crowd went with him. As he drew near to the gate of the town, behold, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she a widow, and a considerable crowd from the town was with her. When the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her, and he said, "Don't weep." Then he came up and touched the stretcher, and the bearer stood still. And he said, "Young man, I say to you, get up." The dead man sat up and began to speak, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, saying, "A great prophet has risen among us. God has visited his people." And this report about him spread throughout the whole country of Judea and the surrounding countryside. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
In the readings the family chose for Shirley, I thought they were very appropriate. In that first reading from the prophet Isaiah, it's a promise of a life beyond this life, that God will prepare for all people a rich banquet, and he'll remove the mourning veil covering all people. It's naturally sadness at the time of a death, and previous a sudden death, or an unexpected death, that we do mourn. It's like a shock to the system. No wonder a lot of people come and gather together just at the sign of that, to comfort the family, but also to pray for the dead and to pray for each other. In the second reading, you hear a very comforting word. We are the children of God. What we are to be in the future is not yet revealed, but we will know we will live with him. And in that gospel, you have Jesus coming into a town and a young man who had died, carried out, and his mother, a widow. She would have been very bereft at that time because no other means of income of living. Her son had died. It was a very sad occasion, and Jesus was moved with compassion, and he raised the young man to life. Ultimately, that young man, of course, died again, and Jesus was just relieving the suffering of people at the time. But I'm sure there's many a time all of us would have wished we could have had that power of Jesus to say, "Young man, get up." And we'd ask to come today just to celebrate the funeral of Shimei. And I know that he was very, very close talk to the sacristan earlier, which we said how Father Paddy had worked an awful lot with Seamus. He was certainly a son of the land. All the stories that I read about him playing in the fields and in his home up and down the hills there, playing with other people, going to the college in agriculture, learning. He was looking after the fields here, driving hay about. I'd say, Father Paddy, so I'm two loads of hay coming down the road, 2 days running. But the third day, I think he was a bit wobbly on the roads. Father Paddy had concern for him. But he was a, say, I think quite a lot of people have gathered because they know that he was not a bad man, he was a good man, he offended nobody. He seemed to be able to entertain people, singing in the bars, even though maybe his singing talents were not acknowledged widely. But even his final hymn that you'll hear today maybe expresses something of him. But we're here today to offer the highest form of prayer that we have for him, the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. We ask that God be good to him, and he will comfort the relatives of those who are left behind. I want to thank Terence, who helped me a lot last night, and who's that other big lady that I can't leave out, Joanne. She's the organiser, and so to help me an awful lot with today. And just to those of you who are friends, and you shame me far better than I would ever know, I ask God's blessing upon all of you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Could I invite Julianne and Orla and Alessa and Pierce, who now will lead us in the prayers of the faithful.
We pray for the Mackle family that in these dark and difficult days they may be sustained by their faith and by the knowledge that they will be reunited with one day in God's heavenly kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, receive us.
We pray for our late Granny Peggy, Granddad James, and Uncle Kevin that they will welcome our Uncle Seamus into their loving arms and that God may bring them into the light of his presence. Lord, hear us.
Lord, receive us.
We pray for all here present that our remembrance of Seamus may be a source of comfort and strength to us. Lord, hear us.
The Mackle family pray for and are eternally grateful to all of this loving community that looked after and nurtured Seamus over the past few years. Lord, we thank you for their love and we ask you to bless them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Pray for all our friends and relatives who have died. Pray for people in our community who died suddenly in the last couple of days, that their families may be comforted also. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Father in heaven, listen to the prayers we have made. We make all our prayers to you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Just be seated. And as we wait for the offertory gifts to be brought up by Orla and Melissa.
May they tell of your peace.
giving to all men that we receive.
Lift up your hearts.
Raise up the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things. You sent us our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and giving for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands and endured his passion to break the bonds of death and bring about the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God,
and
in your glory, Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he. Send down the Holy Spirit upon these like the dewfall. They become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he gave it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Eat this bread and drink this cup and proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, if you celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you held us worthy to be in your presence serving you. Humbly we pray, partaking the body and the blood of Christ, and to be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity with Francis, our Pope, Noel, our Bishop, and all God's people. Remember Seamus, who called out of this world for yourself, that to he who is united with your Son may share his resurrection. Remember all our brothers and our sisters who have died. Welcome them all, Lord, into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray. That was the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, apostles and saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced eternal life. We may praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Stand together as brothers and sisters. Pray in the words Jesus left us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, Deliver us, God, from every evil, grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin. Protect us from useless worrying as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory is yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, I give you peace. My peace I give you. Acknowledge our sin, but of the faith of your church. God, take peace and the unity of your kingdom. For you live forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you all. Lamb of God. Perpetual light shine upon them with your saints forever, for your merciful. Turn the rest of us, O Lord, that perpetual light shine upon them with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Now, it's good to be in communion. If for any reason you can't go to communion today, you're still welcome to call for a blessing. Just let me get the sacraments and just put your hand in the heart. Otherwise, you've been prayerfully in your seats, listening to our instrument, listening to us.
Thank you. because they both had the passion for the farming that very few lacked. Once the farm talk got going, it was hard to get stopped. Known by a lot and loved by all, Shamey was larger than life, a character to say the least. Not many words can be used to describe him. Gentleman is the only one that many could find. A heart of gold, a vitamin tea in one hand, on his road to the Raglan Road through the Ring of Fire. What is your favourite film? It could have been anything, but rest assured, he'd have told you what your favourite film was, irrelevant if you had seen it or not. He wouldn't want to fight down my orcs, he would say, from the stove. But I wonder, does he know what his favourite film is? He had seen them all, from comedy to horror, romance, drama, crime, and even a musical or two. He had seen more films than Exhibition. As we bid the gentleman Shamey farewell from this life to the next, we hope he is looking down on us. This isn't goodbye, friend, it is a see you later. He'll be spoke of for a long time to come, and we'll raise a prayer for the man who was Shamey Wagon.
He was a young infant, he was baptized and received the sign of the cross.
Isaiah spoke about being in the Holy of Holies, the Temple of Jerusalem, the very center of faith, and Chris filled the smoke, felt the presence of God. The incense notes the presence of God among his people. The smoke rising is reminiscent of our prayers rising to God on behalf of Jesus. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive your soul, descendant of the God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May the angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive your soul, descendant of the God the Most High.
Eternal rest God, come to him, O Lord, and perpetual light shall
be. Receive your soul, descendant of the God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father, mercy, give back our brother Seamus in the sure and certain hope that with all who died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day.
Receive his soul and present to God the Most High.
Mercy, Lord, turn towards us as our prayers open the gates of paradise to your servant. Help us to remain behind, to comfort one another with the assurance of our faith, and we will all meet again in Jesus Christ. And we are with you and our brother forever. Make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
On behalf of the family, I want to thank all of you who came out today in respect for Seamus. We're here to join them with a sad time and to pray for them. In peace now, let us take our brother's remains to their place of rest.
His mother.